First Alert weather forecast.
Welcome back. It's 10 minutes after 6, and we had that same system in place that we've had over the course of the weekend that we had yesterday that brought some of us an additional inch, even close to 2 inches of rainfall. Just yesterday, for example, outside of our studio, we got about an inch and a third for yesterday. But now more widespread showers towards our southeast. Those are starting to take a little bit more of a northwesterly track with some pockets of heavier rain and a few embedded thunderstorms that have been associated with that, and a few more developing down towards northeastern Iowa as well. Now, we're expecting more of those chances for some showers and even a few storms throughout the course of today, which could bring some isolated heavy rainfall at times. Now, it'll become a lot more hit and miss later throughout the course of the afternoon and into the evening. Now, we could have a few chances at some scattered showers early tomorrow morning, but those, again, start to fizzle out throughout the course of tomorrow, and we dry things out by tomorrow night. And temperatures pretty close to average over the next couple of days before we start to get in more sunshine by Friday, and those winds take on a bit more of a breezy turn out of the south. That'll usher in those milder temperatures, and we'll see more summer-like temperatures on the way, again, coming up this weekend. But for today, starting off mostly in the 60s, we'll have that widespread cloud cover hanging around, chances at some showers from time to time, and very little change as far as our temperatures are concerned, much like we've seen over the last couple of days. Right now, a lot of us starting off in the low 60s, and relative to our averages, this is very, very mild. We would typically be in the upper 40s, even mid to upper 40s for our overnight lows this time of year. This is about 15 degrees above that. Winds mostly out of the east right now, between 5 to 10 miles per hour, but we'll start to see these ramp up a little bit more throughout the course of the day as well. Now, going through today, starting off with more widespread rain further towards the southeast, much like we're seeing right now, but as we progress through the morning and into the afternoon, these become a bit more scattered. Still not ruling out those chances at some pockets of heavy rain at times that could create some localized flooding concerns. That's just something to keep in mind as well. But by tomorrow morning, some very scattered showers as we hang on to a mainly cloudy sky. Those start to fizzle out and could even see some peaks of sunshine throughout tomorrow afternoon. And going into Thursday, starting off with some patchy fog potentially and a good bit of cloud cover, but you'll notice those winds take on a bit more of a southerly flow. That's what's going to help warm us up later on into the end of the work week. As far as how much more we can expect, areas to the southeast, of course, that are seeing more of that widespread rain, that are seeing some of those heavier pockets now, expected to be around that inch, possibly even up to an inch and a quarter of additional rainfall on top of what we've already seen. Now, this spells some good news for those areas south of I-90, because that's where we have the worst of those drought conditions, as we have D4 drought down that way. The rest of us expect to get anywhere from about a tenth to a quarter, and in some cases, up to about a half inch of rain. Now, as far as temperatures today, again, expect to get into the upper 60s, a little bit of a breeze with those scattered showers, and tonight dipping to the upper 50s. Mainly cloudy, we'll have a few chances at some showers hanging around, but those, again, become a lot more hit and miss. For tomorrow, a bit of a breeze again. Thursday, we dry things out, ultimately getting mostly into the low 70s, so a few degrees above average. But notice as those daytime highs get into the upper 70s and low 80s throughout the course of the weekend, and those overnight lows in the low 60s, that's typically on par with what we would see in June as we open up the month of October. Now for a Sunshine Award, Ryan Carl's like to nominate Quinn Herdlicka and Erica Anderson, and says Quinn is a school counselor at Eau Claire North High School, and he is such a great guy. He works hard every day and he cares about student success. Erica is a secondary school assistant at Eau Claire North. She is the nicest person, and she's a hard worker also. She does her best every day. Now, if you'd like to nominate someone, send us an email or head over to our website at weau.com.